You know, that's a beautiful work of art, and the look of it is indicative of just any one of the guides here at Honey Break. He's got his bands, he's got his calls, his gun. You know, speaking of guides, it's not very often that the guides get to hunt together and have a good time. This week's episode, we've got all the guides together go out on a fun hunt, and you just watch what they do with the ducks here at Honey Break.
See my honey bee. I went down to the South Field just to see my honey bee. Yeah. My mind was in the heaven, but my feet was on the ground. I was running through the South Field. My heart began to pound. Oh, 'cause my honeybee is still there. She's waiting there for me.
Yeah. Well, we're here at Blind 17 this morning. We're going to actually get to make a fun guide hunt this morning. See, we've got old Polly from the lodge out here with us. We just went through a safety video or a safety meeting and told Paul the best place for his calls to be was in his pocket. So it ought to be a good hunt this morning.
Yeah.
We got none? Wait or take it.
Get over top, let's take it. Mark. Here. Drop.
Way out there on 17, watching the wind blow and the clouds, but there's always hope.
Sure.
Because there's a big old pond right over yonder.
I was going to say, we tutored to him quite a bit, didn't we?
We earned him.
He proved us a little too close the last time, though.
Not for you.
Old Cash is out there. Ain't got any meat on his bones. He's just freezing. And you got his dadgum vest up there in the locker. Well, you can sure use it, because
you don't feed his dog and you steal his clothes.
That's why he's such a good hunter. He's hungry.
Oh, old Cashman.
Hoping to run into a bowl of food out there.
Poor old Cashman, he's picking on the skinny kid. Just because Blake's fat, he wants to pick on the skinny kid.
The morning of today, get ready to get Paul back to the lodge, get ready for all our guests coming in. We had a good guide hunt this morning. Saw a lot of birds, a lot of high birds, so that means we got birds in the area. That's a good thing. We killed a limit of pintail, snow goose, a couple mallards, a few teal. Good enjoyable hunt. Now we got to get to work, get ready for our clients coming in. I'm sure Blake's got to go to that lake and finish his limit out today, so we'll let him get out of here and go to the lake. I may even go with him this morning, because I don't have the three birds. I think Drew killed his six and Paul killed his six. I got three and Blake don't have none.
I ain't got none, that's right.
So we're gonna go get ready and get ready for tomorrow. This episode of the Honey Break Experience is brought to you by Beretta, 500 years, one passion. Mossy Oak, it's not a passion, it's an obsession. Gator Tail, taking you places you never thought possible. This is the Honey Break Experience. Yeah, this morning we got Landon here with us, Landon White and Joe Height. We don't get to hunt together a lot, you know, so today we had a little day off, so we're gonna try to get in here and kill 18 birds, enjoy ourselves, relax this morning. We're not guiding, we're having a little guide hunt, and everybody ought to do good this morning. Well, we're doing all right this morning. Got five already, about 5 minutes in the shooting time. If Joe could shoot just a hair better, we'd probably have eight. I don't believe I've killed a bird yet. I know I had. I got six more. Had a few teal come in. And old Joe cut one out the bunch. He finally hit one. I'm proud of it. Good duck working though right there. You know, this year we've had tough conditions. We drive, we've been in a long time. We don't have a lot of water. When we do have water, we're killing a few ducks, so we're having to pressure them so hard. But every duck that comes in gets shot at, so they can't stay in the area. Well, man, ended out pretty strong. Wasn't a great hunt due to dry conditions, no weather. Had a good day yesterday, a little front come through. We got a little south wind right now, but it ain't much going on. Looks like it's about over. We didn't have a bad hunt. Killed 10 or 11 birds, a few gray ducks, a few teal. Wasn't bad at all compared to what we've been doing.
That's right. Like me and you have been talking about, Jared, it's just so dry right now, and the water level is hard to keep up. There's been thousands of gallons of diesel pumped up. People lose water this time for seepage and evaporation. And what little weather we get, we just got to keep staying mobile and bouncing around these different holes and do what we can do until we get a big push until the second split.
Hi, I'm Drew Keith. Here today with good friend Steve Snell from Gun Dog Supply and Joe Perron from Champion Retrievers. What we're going to talk about today is the proper use of check cords and drag lines, and why it's always important to use one of those, Joe.
It's important to use these check cords and drag lines because you keep good control of your dog.
You can keep her in the area where you want to train her and give her commands.
Drew, we like a small snap. With a young dog, we're going to start off with about a 6-foot rope. Mm-hmm. We're going to move up to a 10 or 15 foot as they get a little bit bigger. And then we're going to move up to a larger rope with about 30 foot. And you want this on your dog all the time when you're doing your basic commands. Mm-hmm. You want to be able to get control over that dog at any point. And the nice thing about a drag line is that as that dog's moving along, instead of calling the dog and the dog not coming to you, you go over there, you pick up the rope. At that point, you call the dog and you can make him come to you.
That's right.
And that way you can always enforce your commands.
That's right.
Here. Here. Good, good girl. Good, good girl. Sit.
It's a lot like, you know, using a smaller rope like that, so they really don't even notice it's on them.
Exactly.
You get ready to reinforce that command. You know, you don't want to start any bad habits off. You want to have good positive habits you want to create. This is your Honey Break Gun Dog Tip of the Week.
Richard's been hunting with me ever since he was about 10 years old. His dad and I were very good friends, and he's been guide for me for a few years, and we've brought him on in Honey Break the last couple years, doing a wonderful job, and we're getting to hunt together today. Really looking forward to it. Kill it. See, we're back on cue today, baby. Long tree right there, Rich.
So that ain't nothing for old Tiny.
Good shot.
Tiny!
Back online now, brother. Rich, look over there, buddy. I ain't seen no rain in a while. A little cloud right over on that side of the lake, on the east side of the lake. We're supposed to. We got a 40-50% chance of rain today. Hey, we may get some severe weather. We need some severe weather to move these birds around and get some water on some spots that don't have any water right now. We got plenty of feed. Honey Break is full of feed. We just got to get some water on it right now. That's what we're looking for.
Tiny!
Catahoula Lake, Drake Camelback. Big fine bird. People come from all over the country to kill this bird on this lake. Ha ha ha!
Rock 'em.
That's right.
Today, we still don't have much of a wind, but we got a promise of a front coming tonight. These birds are moving in front of the front. Some birds right there. And they're coming around. They're starting to work. It's new birds coming on the lake where it's not the same old birds looking at everything. This is just the beginning of a great day. That's a fine mallard hen. We try not to shoot as many Susies as we can unless they get close enough to shoot. Because if they get close enough to shoot, we whack them. There's a time for conservation. It's 10 months out the year. For 60 days out the year, we whack them. This morning, a little after 7:30, we've had a good morning. The front's gonna blow through tonight, and tomorrow it's gonna be even better.
This episode of the Honey Break Experience is brought to you by War Eagle Boats, America's most versatile boat company. K2 Coolers, real value, real cold. Honey Break Lodge and Outfitters, the experience of a lifetime. This is the Honey Break Experience.
This morning we're out on Catahoula Lake hunting with Richard and Bucky. This will be our last little guide hunt this morning because we're going to get super busy starting tomorrow. Lots of clients coming in. Catahoula Lake, world-renowned place, holds about 75% of the whole canvasback population comes here sometime in the winter. A lot of people come to this lake just to shoot one duck, canvasback, and we are loaded up with them for sure. It's pretty much guaranteed that every day you can get your limit of canvasback out here. Ladies and gentlemen, that's the King Can right there. Drake canvasback, beautiful bird, big-bodied bird. Flies a lot faster than you think he does. On record, he's one of the fastest birds it is, even with that big body. A lot of people think the teal is the fastest, but that's your bird right there. When he gets up in that jet stream, he can come to you quick.
What I'm talking about, don't let them get out of here, boy. Put them all on the water, make the sky fall, baby.
Good hunt. Last day I'm gonna get to hunt with y'all this morning, man. We're gonna get busy tomorrow. We're gonna have a full weekend, be booked up. Next split, it's gonna be wide open. This episode of the Honey Break Experience is brought to you by Drake Waterfowl, innovators in waterfowl hunting. Honey Break Gun Club, Louisiana's finest. Mojo Outdoors. It ain't magic if it ain't mojo. This is the Honey Break Experience.
Next time on the Honey Break Experience.
Well, it's the day before duck season starts, the 2012-2013 season. It's controlled chaos.
Sit. Tash!
Good shooting, guys. Yeah, big bull spring.
Found that hole. I hear y'all.
Get him. Good shot. Cash! Good shot.
Only on the Pursuit Channel.